Come on, what are these judges smoking? Are they even watching the goddamn fights? God damn.
I don't know if he's on drugs or what his deal is, you know.
Corey Sandhagen got robbed against DJ Dillashaw. Before I continue with this ranting, click the subscribe button, you know the drill, and like this video. So, first and foremost, I wanna say that I'm glad to see DJ Dillashaw back. I disagreed with 2 years sentence. I think that was a pretty harsh by the UFC and USADA. Anyway, it was good to see him back. I had DJ Dillashaw losing this fight, but he won with guts and bruises. He got beat the fuck up by Corey Sandhagen. It was a complete, not a complete domination, but it was a complete beatdown by Corey Sandhagen. Corey Sandhagen was just hurting him over and over and over again throughout the fight. He almost finished him in the second round. That second round can easily be a 10-8 round. Corey Sandhagen didn't get hurt, not even once throughout the fight. Sandhagen connected a couple of those nasty knees, and these big shots landed over and over again. So the only thing that DJ Dillashaw did do is that just push forward, get hit, and try to take him down. Some of these people who are saying that DJ Dillashaw won the fight because Corey Sandhagen was going backwards. What else he is supposed to do? If you are a striker and you're fighting against a guy who's trying to wrestle you, of course you're gonna go backwards. Or else you're gonna be taken down. When Khabib fought Justin Gaethje, for example, what did Justin Gaethje do? He was going backwards and hitting big shots. But later on, Khabib took him down and submitted him. DJ Dillashaw could not do that. He couldn't take Corey Sandhagen down. Or if he did, Corey Sandhagen just got quickly up. He didn't do any damage when he was hugging him. That was all he was doing. He was hugging Corey Sandhagen from behind. That's not a control. That's hugging. Control is when you put a fighter in a position where he cannot do anything. And then you start, you know, punching in the face or kicking or whatever. Just like what Khabib does. Khabib controls his opponents. DJ Dillashaw didn't do that. But he's very, very smart person. He has very high fight IQ and he's a veteran. He has a lot of experience. And he knew that the judges will see his way. He knew that. That's why he was holding Corey Sandhagen. This was a clear robbery. I had Corey Sandhagen winning the second round, fourth round, and fifth round. If we look at the judges' scorecard, there was a one judge that had DJ Dillashaw winning the fourth round. Like, how the hell you can give DJ Dillashaw the fourth round? If we look at the stats, Corey Sandhagen landed a lot more significant strikes in the fourth round. He landed 26 out of 65, and DJ Dillashaw landed 19 out of 61. If we look at the overall significant strikes, Corey Sandhagen had 128 out of 281, and DJ Dillashaw had 110 out of 268. So Corey Sandhagen had overall more significant strikes. But the thing is that Corey Sandhagen's strikes were a million times more effective, and Corey Sandhagen didn't get hurt once throughout the goddamn fight. I feel so sad for Corey Sandhagen. Like, golly, what's wrong with these judges? We have Cody Garbrandt even saying that he had Corey Sandhagen winning the fight. He said that Corey Sandhagen did more damage. And DJ Dillashaw didn't do anything with the takedowns. That's not how you should win the fights. Even Khabib came out and said that Corey Sandhagen won 3-2 because of the damage. Everybody's saying that. Look at Corey Sandhagen's face. Like, come on. He doesn't have any bruise, no cuts, nothing. Francis Ngannou has came out against the judges. He said that these judges are ruining these fighters', you know, career. And he's 100% right. This is horrible. I think there should be some kind of way to hold these judges accountable. I don't know how, but this is very, very bad for the fighters. You didn't lose the fight, but you lost the fight because of the goddamn judges who don't know how to judge MMA fights. You never really see this in any other sport except MMA. You see that sometimes in boxing, not because they don't know what they're doing, it's because of the corruption. But in MMA, they don't know what the fuck they're doing. They have no clue. Cory Sandhagen responded on his Instagram. I really, really like his mindset. He's saying that he should have done more to win the fight. He made a couple of mistakes. One of the biggest mistakes that Cory Sandhagen did was that he stayed too long against the cage. You shouldn't let your opponent hug you against the cage for many minutes. I think DJ Dillashaw had like 8 minutes of octagon control time. That's not a smart thing to do. When somebody shoots for the takedown, you have to have underhook right away and push your opponent to the side and leave. Just like Issa Adesanya does. Issa Adesanya doesn't stay against the cage. He doesn't let people hold him for long. He's gone right away. That's what Cory Sandhagen has to do in future. So I think this is gonna be a big learning experience for Cory Sandhagen. He's gonna get better. Trust me, he's gonna get so much better. But congrats to DJ Dillashaw. In the end, he won the fight. He didn't stop pressuring Cory Sandhagen. He didn't stop throughout the fight. But he looked pretty sloppy, slow. His punches were very predictable. You saw Cory Sandhagen evading all the big shots throughout the fight. DJ Dillashaw couldn't hit one big shot against Cory Sandhagen. So you can clearly see that DJ Dillashaw isn't the same guy as before. But you have to remember that he's a lot older. He's 35 years old. But he has the experience, he has the fight IQ, and he can take a lot of punishment. I don't know how he took those hits, especially the knee. Like, those knees were clean, right to the jaw. I don't know how DJ Dillashaw endured that. He might injected EPO right to his jaw. But anyway, congrats to DJ Dillashaw. You did amazing. Good for you. You're gonna get the next title shot. Cory Sandhagen, don't feel depressed. You did amazing. You were the real winner of this fight. Just work on the little mistakes that you made. You are probably gonna fight against Rob Font next. That's gonna be a great fight. But anyway, let me know down in the comment section what you guys think about this fight. Click the subscribe button, like this video if you like. Stay safe, stay healthy. Goodbye.